رسول الله طال بي الحنين.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذ قال الله يا عيسى ابن مريم اذكر نعمتي عليك وعلى والدتك إذ أيدتك بروح القدس تكلم الناس في المهد وكهلا وإذ علمتك الكتاب والحكمة والتوراة والإنجيل إلى آخر الآية صدق الله العظيم. I recited some part from a verse of Surah Maida. It is verse number 110. And this verse talks about Allah's relationship with one of His great messengers, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. Hazrat Isa alayhi salam was sent for the guidance of Bani Israel, and he was the last messenger who was sent in the long chain of the prophets of Bani Israel. Hazrat Isa alayhi salam is one of the prominent messengers in the chain of the messengers of Allah, because Hazrat Isa alayhi salam was given life without father. And the entire incident of the miraculous birth of Isa alayhi salam is mentioned in Surah Maryam. Allah wanted to show His power, that's why Allah gave life to Isa alayhi salam without a father. Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, like all other messengers, was given knowledge by Allah, as this passage mentions that وَإِذْ عَلَّمْتُكَ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَالتَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلَ, that Allah gave him the knowledge of Torah and the knowledge of Injil both. We believe that all the messengers of Allah are given knowledge directly from God. That's why the knowledge of the messengers of Allah is error-free. Their knowledge is divine. And they don't have the worldly teachers. So Hazrat Isa alayhi salam was also given the knowledge of two books, that was the knowledge of Torah and Injil. Torah was revealed on Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, and Injil was revealed on Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. But the passage mentions that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam was given the knowledge of both the books. It means that Injil didn't abrogate Torah, but this book was basically an addendum, an addition to Torah. That's why Torah is known as Old Testament and Injil is known as the New Testament, and both the books together are known as Bible. The passage also mentions that, like all other messengers, Allah also supported Hazrat Isa alayhi salam with miracles. All the prophets were given miracles to prove their prophethood in front of their nations. Obviously, when they will say in front of their nations that we are God appointed and whatever we say is from God and you have to believe in us, otherwise Allah will destroy you. So the people will ask them about the evidence of their prophethood. So that's why Allah gave miracles to all of His messengers. And the miracles were given according to that era. The people were expert in something in that period of time. So the miracles were given related to that particular field. Like Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, his people were very expert in magic, so he was given magical type of miracles. He was given the staff which converted into a snake, and he was given the miracle of radiant hand. But Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, in his time, the people were expert in medicine. So he was given miracles related to that field, that he could cure leprosy with his touch. He could cure a born blind person with his touch. And Hazrat Isa alayhi salam used to make the birds of clay and he used to blow on them and they used to get life. And Hazrat Isa alayhi salam could also give life to a dead person. He used to say Qum bi iznillah, and a dead person used to get life and he used to talk to the people. So Hazrat Isa alayhi salam showed all these miracles to Bani Israel. But Bani Israel, the Jews of Jerusalem, gave him a very tough time and they did not accept him as a prophet. And they called his miracles an evident magic. Regarding Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, there are different beliefs in the three divine religions. The Jews believe in Isa alayhi salam as a fake messenger, na'uzubillah. They don't believe in the miraculous birth of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. That's why they were the enemies of Hazrat Maryam and Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. On the other side, the Christians believed in Isa alayhi salam as the Son of God. And they introduced and innovated the concept of Trinity, that is also shirk. But the correct belief about Isa alayhi salam is that which the Holy Quran tells us, that Isa alayhi salam, though he was given the birth without a father as a miracle from God, but still he does not have any physical relationship with Allah, but he was just a servant of Allah and the messenger of Allah. Like all other prophets, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam was also given a very tough time by his people, the Jews, and they became his enemies and they even tried to kill Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, but Allah saved him. It is said that when the Jews came to kill Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, the first person who jumped into the house of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, Allah gave him the resemblance of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, and Allah raised Jesus up unto the heavens. And the other people considered that person as Isa alayhi salam, and they crucified him. And then afterwards they were in confusion that if he is that person who jumped into the house of Jesus, then where is Isa? He was in his house. And if he is Isa, so then where is that person who jumped into his house first? So the Holy Quran says it about it, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ. They neither killed him and nor crucified him, but they are in doubts. بَرَّفَعَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ, but Allah raised him up unto himself. And there is another version in it that when the Jews came to kill Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, Hazrat Isa said to his disciples who were sitting around him that who will give his life for me today and he will become my neighbor in Jannah. So one of the disciples said, I will do it for you. So Allah gave the resemblance of Jesus to that person. So that person was crucified, and the Jews think that we have crucified Jesus. And even the Christians also believe that he was crucified on the cross. But Muslims believe that Isa alayhi salam was not killed, he was not crucified, but Allah raised him up unto himself, and he will come back, as it is mentioned in the Sahih Ahadith of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. He has to come back and he will kill Dajjal and he will implement the Holy Quran and he will follow the Sunnah of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. So this passage basically about Allah's relationship with Isa alayhi salam, and these are the important points mentioned in this verse. And from this verse and from the story of Isa alayhi salam, Muslims can learn many things today. First of all, this passage strengthens our belief in the great position of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam in the sight of God. Allah sent 1,24,000 messengers, but only 26 are mentioned in the Quran, you know, and Hazrat Isa alayhi salam is one of them. And then from those 26 messengers, some of them are given the books, and one of them is Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, who was given Injil. And Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, that's why, is having a very prominent position in the chain of the messengers of Allah, and Muslims believe in him as one of the greatest messenger, and we give him the due respect. Besides that, the passage tells us that messengers came to the world and to mankind for the guidance of mankind. So we should believe in them. We should give importance to their teachings and their preachings. And if we will follow the teachings of the messenger of Allah, that is the only way of success for mankind in this world and in the next world. So we should not become like the Jews of Bani Israel, who gave a tough time to Isa alayhi salam. And that's why, according to some verses of the Quran, they are in the curse of Allah because of their enmity of the messengers. And like as they tried to kill Isa alayhi salam, they had killed previously some other prophets like Hazrat Zakariya alayhi salam and Hazrat Yahya alayhi salam. So we should learn from the stories of the previous nations that we should not repeat these mistakes, but we should love and respect and obey the messengers, and it gives us a guarantee of success in both of the worlds. Similarly, Allah has mentioned the books over here. All the divine scriptures came for the guidance of mankind. We have Quran today, so we should be attached with the divine guidance. The Holy Quran and all the scriptures tell us about the unseen world, and we don't have any other source of knowledge about the unseen world. Where the human intellect stops working, from there the divine guidance starts leading us. So we should give time to the scriptures, and we should try to understand them, and it is also the way of success in both the worlds. Another important thing which we need to note over here is that Allah has mentioned around four miracles of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam in this ayah, But with every miracle Allah has added, bi'izni, by my leave. You gave life to the dead, by my leave. You cured the leprosy and blindness, by my leave. So what is the significance of mentioning this phrase with all the miracles? Allah wants to make it clear that all these miracles were happening according to the powers of Allah, and Hazrat Isa alayhi salam was just a messenger of Allah and the servant of Allah. If he gave life to the dead person, it doesn't mean that we should believe in him as a part of God, nauzubillah, as the Christians believe in him as one of the three gods. So Allah has mentioned it clearly with all the miracles, that miracles were happening with the permission of Allah, and we should believe in the messengers as servants of God and the messengers of Allah. And the passage also tells us that we should have a strong belief in Allah. If Allah doesn't want something, so it cannot happen. If Allah doesn't want that anyone can harm you, so no one can harm you. So the believers should have trust in God and they should have faith in Allah. Like in this story, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam was alone. He did not have so many companions and he did not have any force to defend him. And all the Jews came to kill him, but Allah saved him. When Allah had planned something, so that will happen. And Allah is always with his messengers, and similarly, Allah is always with his obedient and beloved servants. So no one can harm them if Allah has not planned it, if Allah doesn't allow it. So we should have this faith in God as well. May Allah give us the tawfiq to follow all the teachings of this ayah, and may Allah strengthen our belief in all the prophets and all the scriptures. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Allah.